So I was reading this book called Finding the Magic in You. And I've been sitting here in an injured, bankrupt state here in Pune, just thinking about how did it all kick off. Well, it was 2009 when I spent my last penny in the bank to take gifts and land up at Poonam Sinha's house because it was Shatrughan's birthday. I heard Poonam abuse Anu Ranjan and Shashi Ranjan, saying that she had taught them everything, yet they were not bothered about her. Now that gets me thinking, was she and her husband the ones who used to crawl up like insects on my head when I used to stay in Videocon guest house on the pretext of tutoring me? They nailed my stomach and wrecked my sex life for 15 years. Why? Couldn't achieve my South Mumbai upsheen standards of style and class that you had to wreck my life to make me bloat and fart for 15 years. You fucking bitch. Today, you're going to be exposed. When Anu and Shashi Ranjan had invited me for the great awards, when I was walking the red carpet, they had actually planted a man there to hit me when I was posing for the paparazzi. Why do you think collectively they have terminated so many contracts of mine, starting from Times of India MediaNet deal, to 8 lakhs Hindustan deals, to a 13 lakh Condé Nast deal, to 1 lakh advertorials in Vogue, Cosmo, Elle, you know, so many media contracts, because they don't want me to be splashed over in the media or in the papers, because they're running a sex scam. They have been prostituting me in an unconscious state to the film industry people. And if I'm splashed around in the papers, the film industry people would start offering me roles in the main lead. And I would replace Sonakshi Sinha. That's why they kept on blocking my sunlight and terminating my media contracts. Why else would they steal 35 movies of mine and circulate it among Salman Khan's circle of girlfriends? Do you remember in 401 Windsor, Sonakshi Sinha used to literally sneak into my house whenever I'd come back from a vacation in Singapore, where my sister lives as she's an NRI. She would steal my watches, shoes, bags, clothes, wear them and get her pictures published first before I could even wear my belongings, so that she could prove she's more stylish than me, because she was the one who was prostituting me in an unconscious state for money, movies, and publicity contracts, endorsements. That's why she always wanted to remain superior. Well, you weren't even supposed to be an actor. You were supposed to be a designer. Seeing me, you came in the acting field, and then you took over my life, and you've been getting away with it for 50. Is this not a trap? First, you make me unconscious and prostitute me without my permission. Then you want to hog all the limelight and be the center of attention, and are ready to stoop as low as sneaking into my house and stealing my belongings and wearing them in an unauthorized manner without my permission. Known of a bigger insecure pimp than Sonakshi Sinha and her family. Kept stealing from me and giving it to Salman Khan, as they wanted him to launch Sonakshi Sinha, to butter his toast. Not one movie, not 5 movies, not 10 movies, not 15 movies, not 20 movies, not 25 movies, not 30 movies, but 35 movies in entirety. And the freeloaders kept freeloading, one after the other. And 15 years passed. And you think this bastard freeloader is going to give me a break? Well, the freaking parasite lives off me. Together with their jing bang, God knows how many people did Sinha prostitute me to. From Narang to Dhoot to Khan, they kept on making me unconscious through black magic, jinns and jinnats, and prostituting me. And as Khan was involved, together they killed my father, who was the Director of Investigation, Chief Commissioner of Income Tax, Mumbai, and had high voltage contacts which could easily get them behind the bars to safeguard themselves after having plundered and exploited me for 15 years, no less. They murdered my father by black magic, by jinns and jinnats, and for that they are going to jail. And nobody in this entire universe can stop that from happening. In fact, Seema Khan and Malaika Arora by purpose kept Sonakshi Sinha ahead of me so that they could get gifts, they could get vacations, they could get, you know, my house. Who has possession of my Bombay house, Seema Khan? Huh? Who has possession of my Bombay house? This is how Sonakshi Sinha, sitting in the middle like a shikhandi, kept on robbing all that was meant for me and giving it to the Khans, who shamelessly kept freeloading it off me. It's these three bitches who've hacked my phone and keep stealing my work. In fact, today, if I don't have any money or any friends or any movies at this need of hour, it's because of these three cunts. Seema Khan, Malaika Arora and Sonakshi Sinha. Whatever was my niche, they kept on making my duplicates and replacing me with them. When MTV India had confirmed me as a VJ, they cut my card and put Malaika Arora and Amrita Arora there. Then after Big Boss, Shatrughan Sinha put a gin in me and sold me off to Salman Khan and his family. And collectively Sinha and Khan constructed a troll of Pooja Mishra called Sunny Leone and made her a VJ on MTV with a show called Splits Villa. She had the audacity to call me as a contestant on that third grade show, which when I refused, she called a girl on the show with the name of Pooja Mishra and humiliated and demeaned her to assert her superiority. Is this the treatment you mete out to the Director of Investigation of Income Tax who served Government of India for 40 years? They would never let me go to places I would enjoy being at, meet people I would enjoy to spend time with. In fact, I was banned from all the award ceremonies, from all the red carpets. I haven't been overseas in the past 5 years. They wouldn't let me get out of India. Why? So that they could copy my style of dressing, my hairstyle, my makeup, and be Pooja Mishra in front of the paparazzi. After all, they sold me off to Salman Khan and his family, who were using me in every way. So how could Pooja Mishra be seen while they roamed around in chartered flights, leading my lux life, clicking their champagne flutes, enjoying the Mile High Club? I lay here in a cage like a sex toy, trapped and imprisoned in Pune for 9 years. I shifted back to Bombay after my dad's death to run away from the deep depression I was suffering from. For 90 days in my car house, both Sinha and Khan wrecked me. Sinha in the insecurity that I would replace Sonakshi. After all, I was Eklavya, who they had lived off for 15 years. And they gave the impression to Akshay Kumar and all these people in the film industry that I was a part of the group, when all they did was plunder and exploit me. Even Khans, Seema Khan and Malaika Arora, left no stone unturned to harass me. So much so that I lodged 11 police complaints and finally left Bombay with viral fever. That night, both these bastards, Sinha and Khan, partied. Well, what they don't know is that they'll have to pay 1 crore worth of compensation for those 90 days as I'm filing a court case. Whenever the going gets good for me, who starts shoving Sonakshi Sinha in my production ventures? Well, I released a publicity still of Hotter Than You, of me in a cage with the door open, indicating how desperately I wanted to break free from this cancer of Jinn and Jinnat. And recently I saw on a casting director's Instagram handle, the same creative but with two girls. I'm going to post that after this video so that you can see how they've done ek ka do, buy one get one free, buy one get one free. As I have been traded to the Khans. So the Khans themselves shoved Sonakshi Sinha inside my projects or tried to make a pathway for her. So as to say thank you for selling me to them for free. And then they tied me up to Salman Khan, who kicked me around, emotionally drained me and banned me in entirety. And kept on making Sonakshi Sinha into Pooja Mishra. Then they did Vashikaran between him and Sonakshi Sinha too to make him crazy about her. So much so that he backstabbed his own brother Arbaaz Khan and took Prabhu Deva as the director of Dabang 3 so that Sonakshi Sinha gets a meaty role, good dialogues and songs. And you all know what they did to me when they were shooting in Jaipur. By purpose they put gins in me to burn and to make me masturbate and sexually harass me. I think Salman Khan has forgotten films like Action Jackson directed by Prabhu Deva as well as Tube Light, which were big turkeys on the box office, because that's what's going to be the fate of such a film for which I've been harassed so badly.